that was a great win. Got a lot of guys some experience. Didn't start out the game like we wanted to, but I think that's a blessing in disguise that forces us to make sure we do everything we can to be sharp at the start of the game. Was really impressed with a number of performances, especially by our defense and our secondary. But it's going to be good to get into conference play and start the grind here on Saturday.
First question to Matt Zimmer from the Argus Leader.
John, is there something you can do or will do this week to maybe ratchet up the intensity in practice a little bit, just in that this is, you know, a much better team that you're facing this week than you have the last couple of weeks?
Maybe the best team we're facing up to this point in the season. You know, what our assistants remind me to do is, Matt, business as usual. Don't make one game bigger. Don't make one conference opponent bigger. And so I've already told them how good Southern Illinois is, and they'll see that on film. And so I think that'll really take care of itself. I don't think I'll have to do that.
So other than that, nothing changes?
No, nothing changes. I mean, we're going to work on certain things that fundamental stuff that we're still working, trying to get better at. But no, we're not going to practice longer. We're not going to have more team sessions. Nothing like that.
How impressed are you with the job that Nick Hill has done there? I mean, obviously, you know, they were struggling a little bit under Dale Lennon, a guy who's kind of a legend around here, and then Nick steps in as a very young first-time head coach, and he really seems to have got it going there.
Yeah, I'm impressed with Nick, and Dale Lennon is one of my best friends in coaching, so, you know, there are situations for certain coaches that don't click, don't work for whatever reason, and there's situations that it's perfect for the coach that's there, and I think Nick is the perfect guy right now, and he's an SIU guy, and he's got a great vision, great energy. He's a young guy, and so very impressed. I like Nick. I like him a lot, and I hope he has success. I just have to worry about him once a year, sometimes once a year, sometimes twice a year. Well, in this case, three times this year. Yeah.
Yeah. That being the case, I mean, you just played them twice not too long ago. Are they very similar to the team you played twice in the spring? Are they different? I know there's a new quarterback. What do you see from them?
No, I think they're very similar. They do a lot of stuff on offense. They always have. I think that's, reflective of Nick and his offensive background. And defensively, I think they've gotten better in the sense that their players are a year older. I know they have some guys that are new, but I do think they play really good defense. They love zone defense, which allows people to see what's going on. So it's a very good football team right now.
Next question is to Zach Borg from Dakota News Now.
Coach, kind of along that line, how much different – what kind of look do you see from their quarterback? How much different was he than Labanowitz? Because I know obviously that was – LeBanowitz played pretty well in the playoff game, and you're going to see something completely different this week.
Hey, Dean. I think they're somewhat similar. I thought the thing that LeBanowitz did was he got the ball out really, really quick. I thought, you know, and I haven't spent a lot of time on watching that game. I watch cut-ups so you don't get as big a feel. And I try to lock in on one game at a time, so – but I think both are really good quarterbacks, and this guy can make all the throws, so he'll be a threat. And then they run the Wildcat more than anybody, and so they have that threat of a running quarterback scenario with their big back, and that always makes you work really hard during practice.
This is a kind of a unique challenge. You're playing a team three times in one year. You basically know. Is it kind of hard to find anything new against them to do, or vice versa when you have played them three times?
You know, I think like with the defense, I think the preparation is a little easier because you have your rules and you've defended them, and so you're not opening up a new book and starting over. I think offensively, that's where you try to come up with a new wrinkle here or there. so that they're not honed in, number one, on what we did the last two games against them, what we've done the first four games during the season. But that's offensive coaches do that all the time. I think it's a benefit to have played them twice and then the third time because you know them better. The challenge is how are you going to figure out how to attack them in a different way?
Next question to Todd Hefferman.
Hi, Stig. Just what do you like about your quarterback's development since he started this fall?
It's good to see you, Todd. Chris has been a great leader, and from a guy that didn't get here until June, I think that's remarkable. He's had some really good games. This last game was not up to his level of expectation nor ours, but we did win handily. We didn't need him to have to make the play to win the game or to get a first down or whatever. And the other thing I like about him is one thing and this is about a champion. He doesn't waste a second. He doesn't waste a second in terms of not being focused. He's always focused on the practice field. When he's in the weight room, he's totally committed. And so he, with his approach to his position, I think he draws guys with him to a higher level.
And obviously Pierre is running against everybody, but he's averaging almost 10 yards a carry lifetime against SIU. How are we able to get him in some space and have to give him some room to make something happen against this defense?
Yeah.
Traditionally?
Yeah, I think it starts with the, you know, Pierre's obviously a really good player, and there's a lot of really good players in the Missouri Valley Football Conference. But it starts with our big guys and our tight ends, and we feel we've got a really good offensive line. I know their coordinator moves those inside guys a bunch, gives you a bunch of different looks, a lot more variety on the inside than on the outside by the defensive ends. So it's going to be up to our big guys to be able to pick up those movements and knock them off the ball. And then Pierre, when he's in the open space, he's really tough to bring down.
Southern's done a good job of not giving up a lot of big 30, 40, 50-yard touchdown plays this year. How well prepared do you think your team is to put 12 plays together in a row if you have to this weekend?
Yeah, you know, we haven't had to do that very often. We've had a lot of big plays, even against Colorado State in the opener. And so we love to throw the ball deep. That's not going to change. Credit their defense. Play zone defense. Keep people inside. You know, when the ball's supposed to bounce, make it run lateral. And so it's going to be a Jackson Yankee, a Jaden Yankee against one of their DBs. It's one of those guys going to have to make a play in terms of our team. But again, very impressed with their defense. You bet.
Next question to Marcus Traxler from the Mitchell Daily Republic.
Back to your quarterback for a minute. You know, you mentioned some of the intangibles and the leadership that he's brought to the team. Is there one aspect on the field, you know, between the lines that you've been most impressed with him?
Well, I'll quote Zach Lujan, who played quarterback here and is his position coach. Early in the season, Zach said that Chris Oladokun's the best quarterback that he's seen on the field. Now, that doesn't take anything away from the Taryn Christians or Zach Lujan's or Austin Sumner's, Keaton Heidi's, Jabari Gibbs. What it does is it says Chris Oladokun's a special, special player because those other guys had really good careers and are having good careers.
Yeah, you've had those good quarterbacks, you know, Christian and Lujan, and then you've had some rotating here in the last few years, and this has been maybe the most successful run in school history. What does it say about how the rest of the team has handled that change in quarterback, about how the program has run, and they've handled, you know, different quarterbacks really well?
Well, I'm a defensive guy, but when I became a head coach, I had a mentor tell me, You need to have a good quarterback, right? And so his coaching philosophy was that if you don't have a good quarterback, it's going to be a long season, going to be long games and so on. So I think everybody recognizes that. And how has our team accepted Chris? I mean, he jumped in a huddle the first week he was here. Nobody knew who he was, and he broke him down. I mean, that's the kind of young man he is. He's a great leader. He's got great positive energy. He's a great friend to many that he didn't know, and he didn't know anybody when he got here. Didn't know where South Dakota was when he got here. And so he's just a really special individual and a really good football player.
Next question to Tanner from Kellum.
Coach, last week you were talking a little bit and how they reminded you a bit of you guys back before when you played Georgia Southern, and you guys lost handily, but it kind of gave you a gauge of what you wanted to be one day. Now you fast forward, 17 years, and with a win this week, you could possibly move to number one, the top team in the FCS during the season. Are rankings something that you put any value into the season, or is that something you kind of brush to the side?
The only time I spend on it is because of you deal with a lot of boosters, so it gives you something to talk about, honestly. And so our guys know it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter that we were picked to win the conference. Those things don't matter. You have to go out and do it and earn those things. And the goal would be to be number one at the end of the season. But this year, I will say this. This year, Michael Griffin addressed the team at a team meeting. He brought it up to me. I said, address the team. He's one of our captains. He stood in front of the team. He said, you know, if we claim we're going to be the number one team, let's start acting like it. And we've talked about that every week. What does a number one team look like? So instead of worrying about the rankings, really inside the locker room, what does a championship team look like? And let's be that team, because that's a choice. And so that's maybe kind of a side shoot, but that's how we've used rankings or that concept this fall.
Coach, how excited are you to get into a conference play to have the atmosphere and the crowd that you're going to have? It's been incredible. It's been maybe even a little surprisingly strong, considering those were two opponents that nobody had really had any history around here. How excited are you to kind of really see what kind of home field advantage you can have now that the games are a little more important and the crowds might even get bigger?
Well, I hope they get bigger. I hope they come to impact the game. But in answer to your question, I'm really excited, because this is where you set yourself up to – try to compete for the prize at the end. You know, the non-conference was important. The Indiana State game obviously kicked it off. Now there's this long run of conference teams. Many of them are ranked, and it's an opportunity for you to if you're good enough to solidify yourself to get into the playoffs. So I mean, that's what we work for. So let's bring it on and let's see how good we are.